a gross understatement by saying that I wasn't so disappointed with our performance tonight. Not taking anything away from Delaware State. Clearly, you know, we have to come to grips with what we are. And offensively, we are just we are so inefficient on offense. It's just so damaging to us, night in and night out. So we got to come to grips with it. That's what we are. And we got to continue. We found, you know, our defense was good enough to win tonight. But offensively, you know, 15 turnovers, you leave 10 points on the foul line. We had one or two assists at halftime. So clearly, still trying to seek answers as we continue to move forward. And we'll get back at it tomorrow with a great test and challenge going to Ohio on Saturday. So very disappointing, extremely disappointing in terms of our performance tonight.
Questions, Dennis?
Well, obviously, you didn't see this coming.
Another gross understatement. Nope, didn't see it coming. We had a great week of practice. I'm a broken record now. I don't want to. I don't know. I don't know.
What can you put your finger?
It's hard to. And that's my job. I know that, you know, and then you're asking me the question. And trust me, no one in Cabell County or this part of the state is struggling to find those answers more than me and my staff. Assure you of that. You know, like I said, we responded with great attitude, effort. Our focus was excellent. You know, right up until, you know, I don't know, maybe we didn't have enough energy legs. I don't, you know, maybe I wore them out. I don't know. I don't think I did. I backed off enough the last couple of days. We continue to befuddle me. I've got to figure it out. It's my responsibility as the head coach. I apologize to our fans. Great fan base. A nice turnout tonight on a Wednesday. No students. But we'll continue to plug away at it, that's for sure.
Tom, previous coaching jobs by you, other seasons. Is a game like this tend to be finally a wake-up call?
I'm not a wake-up call guy, to be honest with you, Jack. You know, I'd like to think that, it's a troubling loss, and I make no mistake about it. You know, and then again, I'm not taking anything away from Delaware State. They obviously play the way they play, deliberate. They hold the ball, so they put you in the grind early. Got to make baskets to press. When we made the run, we were in pressure. We were scoring. We were, you know, getting into some pressure. So, but we're just so inefficient on offense. Inept, I clearly don't have enough adjectives to describe it right now, and it's collective. It's not one guy. 15 turnovers. It wasn't just guards. It was different guys turning the ball over. Keep moving. Keep plugging away.
How much positive did you get out of the 16 minutes from the Mayo?
We lost, and I'm positive in that.
You were talking about the turnovers. I'm looking, especially the assist to turnover ratio. I know, you said it's not.
He didn't walk out of the locker room. The kid is not playing. He's hurt. He's the third leading assist guy in the country. Mm-hmm. You take him, and those two guys aren't. Canty and Kane aren't playing.
Right.
So I'm not trying to do the math. I mean, we got guys that aren't making plays. They're not setting up guys. They're not making plays for other guys. We don't have enough guys. Maybe we don't have guys that can do it. I don't know. It's obviously alarming when our assist ratio, has plummeted in the last couple of weeks. And I didn't mean to cut you off there. We don't have enough guys making plays for other guys.
Tom, what is the latest on Kane's availability, possible return? Anything new?
Only thing that'll be new is when he plays.
Anything else?
Thank you.